Thank you.
We had a very nice power point expert to recent development in laparoscopic surgery. Audience are welcome to have clear if they have doubts. If no doubts, then we can go for next.
Can I ask one question to the audience? The drugs that are used for the weight reduction, sibutamine and other drugs, they say up to 2 years you can give. And I'm sure, I don't have any belief in that. I want the audience to let me know, you know, whether they really believe in these drugs, is it being useful, or is it going to give a result which is going to be permanent? Because I believe it's only a temporary phenomenon where it, you know, it acts at the digestive level or central secretory level and stops eating. So if anybody can help me here, I'll be happy.
But the surgery you cannot, it is not indicated for everybody. That is also the other end of the problem.
Correct.
There are many psychological patients who have got binge eating disorder, a severe depression, who may not follow your strict guidelines. That also has to be...
Yeah, I agree with you totally, because that is why we have a team involved. We have a psychiatrist, we have an endocrinologist, we have a physician, we have a diabetologist, all work on it first. Only when they give permission comes the surgical side. 90% of them gets filtered at the level. You don't get that 90%, only 10% who are all okay with it, and then only they do a very good trial with diet and exercise, then they come on to surgery.
There's a malabsorption which we use requires replacement therapy.
Yes.
And some of the drugs are very sensitive, especially the oral anticoagulant. Those things are also has to be in a, anyway. It's not, but the one question is that who is the ideal laparoscopic surgeon? Is a gastroenterologist like you, or a general surgeon? Because National Board offers DNP in gastroenterology and also the fellowship in medical invasive surgery, and gynecologists, they got their own fellowship. So who is the ideal?
That's a very good question. I'll tell you one thing. The most important thing is now MGR Medical University has started a fellowship program in laparoscopy, which we have been selected. Now we are projecting to them that we are laparoscopic abdominal surgeons, not laparoscopic gastrointestinal surgeons. That means we do all GA surgery, we'll also do bariatric surgery, and we'll also do hernias. That's some point. That is how one should look at it. See, most important thing is not the exposure, but he should be good in gastroenterology at the same time, he should be good in laparoscopy. And if you have a surgeon who meddles away with the patient and has a death on table with an obese patient, it's going to be extremely difficult for other good surgeons to catch patients. I'm finding it difficult to convince obese patients.
So ideally speaking, in the future, every general medical surgeon, a trainee has to be exposed to this.
Yes, that's what they have to be exposed. It's important. The patient's life is very
important. It saves them to stay in the hospital. That in that case, a laparoscopy is a very hospital expenditure.
You do only oral laparoscopy or you do other surgery also?
I'm basically open surgery. I've been a postgraduate of Dr. Rangabhashan. We do only open surgeries till 1991. I was a professor for 20 years in Amsterdam. I started my work in 91, now it's only 2 decades.
Okay.
But now we find laparoscopy is a great advantage, and most of the things can be done through laparoscopy, but most of the things, sometimes you should be more prone and then leave your ego and open the patient. That will be the best part.
I mean, how many conversions do you now?
Conversions we don't have. In laparoscopic gallbladder, we don't have any conversions at all. All my assistants who work with me are quite happy. And hiatus hernia we do. Where you get conversion is in hysterectomy. Sometimes what happens, you get severe endometriosis, you have no place to work with the lab instruments, a large fiber, then you have to convert to
laparoscopy.
Otherwise,
mostly no conversion at all.
99.9% no conversion myself.
Sir,
what is
the
bilateral
cyst?
Yeah.
We have learned that sometimes the spillage can cause anaphylaxis.
I agree with you. See, what normally we do is we put in all those trials, hypertonic saline and cover it, and then inject the albendazole for some time, and we, after 2 minutes, hypertonic saline injected, then we pass, under control system, we pass in a troca and remove the sponges. Okay, now the biggest disadvantage, if you spill it, you get general hydridosis, more than anaphylaxis. Anaphylaxis never hurt, to be honest with you. This stuff. But hydridosis of this, you get hydridosis all over your body. That should be definitely good. See, it is not the right operation to do, to be honest. Laparoscopy is not there. But being in a center, teaching center, we also do. Only 7 cases we have. But 7 cases, till now, we don't have any.
One of the large hernia, you said you do a liposuction. Normally, our professor used to scrape the fat to repair the hernia.
Liposuction, we
don't do. Different body removing the fat, sir.
Liposuction, we don't do for large hernias. large hernias is better to do an open tummy tuck procedure. Yes? There are more lipectomies and cephalic. Remove skin fat, expose the hernia, define the margin, completely reduce conducts and put in a nice mesh so that you cover the normal area and the virgin area. So no new hernia cuts. Then you bring the structure of the skin, bring it out. Liposuction meant for only localized fat, remember the point. Hip fat, thigh fat, or somewhere here, localized fat, very good results. But not for a general man. Including male appearance, I don't recommend a liposuction. Female appearance, they do ask me, please remove this fat also and everything. That's okay. That is fine. But for male, fat is not good. Again, if you've got a very large, obese patient, never think of localized procedure like liposuction. It's a potato.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.